We have a very short story about next speaker. Who's ready for our next speaker?
Woo!
Alright. Yeah, I've known our next speaker long before even I joined ATSS. I found him on Facebook and I connected with him. And then I went to meet him for coffee because we have the same passion on personal branding. But the difference is he wrote a book called Personal Branding 247 and I haven't written a book. coming up! I've been writing for 3+ years and it's coming up. And not only that, after that when I got to know him on a deeper level, I realized he's an amazing person. Who agrees with me? Andrew Chow is an amazing person. And he showed me as a complete newbie 4 years ago what it means to have a personal brand. And it's not just about the suit or what you call yourself, it's really about being an amazing person. Can we now give him a standing ovation and welcome Andrew Chow!
Thank you very much. I remember 7 years ago, I had this night where I was a very new president and I was supposed to give the welcome speech and it scared me to hell. Really, I don't know how you do it. But I have one good advice for you. Yeah? To be a good president, you need to drink a lot. You need to drink a lot, yeah. So I'm going to give you something.
Cheers.
All right. Later on, but not now. I also want to acknowledge several people. I'm not going to give an intro, but I want to just acknowledge several people here. One of the first few people that I came to APSS and greeted me, and he seems to know who I am, even though I was a nobody, it was Christian Chua. On the night I became president, there was one newcomer and he come to me and says, I'm so new to Singapore and I really need help and you know this is a great community, can you connect me? And this person today is also a CSP, Avi Lima. And then two presidents after me, I've not seen him for a long time in APSS and today I see him, I'm so happy and he said he came for me. Raymond Thomas, come. Last person. Thank you. And of course, every time when I come here, I must acknowledge one person. She has big shoes that I have to fill. Alright, so I took over from a wonderful lady, Shirley.
Yeah.
Shirley, I took over from Shirley, alright? Okay. So, alright. Today, I'm not going to just speak to you, I'd rather be your facilitator. I like what Andre has said just now and our message kind of link, but this part is really a customization of being iconic. Because you are really different. You and I are different, but we are not difficult. Yeah? Sometimes we see people as different from us. Oh, you're difficult because you're not my type, right? I used to be a matchmaker. Yes, I used to be, you don't believe me? Google my name on YouTube, you'll find all my events there. But I must say I no longer do it. All right, if you want a partner, please go to somewhere else, all right? All right. So I often have ladies to come and speak to me and say, Andrew, I just can't find good guys in the world. And when they have good guys, the ladies will say to the guy, I like you, but you are not my type, right? So what is this type all about? We all have a type. Your type and my type are different. But we are essentially making a difference by being different. So today, I want to play a game with you. I want you, for the next 5 minutes, to discover who you really are. And it's a good time for me to get to know all of you. So, on your table, maybe not now. I just want to share four things you need to know about personality. And number one, I'm not here to debate why you're like that and why I'm like this. I'm not a psychologist, I'm not an expert, but our personality defines our world. Let's face it, your world and my world are very different. If our world collide, guess who needs to give? Depends on who is the boss, right? Number two, it actually dictates the way how we adjust to our environment. Have you ever heard people say, last time I wasn't like this, but after joining this company, I become like this, right? So you are being merged with the environment. Thirdly, it's you react differently to the same situation. If today this chandelier drops next to Jasmine, all of us will have a different response. Let's face it. Lastly, it dictates the way how we engage each other, how we talk to each other. Yeah? Please don't look at the lights, it won't fall. Don't worry, we are covered. So our personality determines how we care for the things around us. Do you care about being iconic? You ought to be. But that is not the only thing that we are going after. Because you and I, we are so different. Let's face it, not all of us will be iconic. But if you can be influential, you are iconic to the most important people in your life. And that is most important. Being iconic to the most important people in your life, your tribe, your audience, is most important. You can't be all to all. You can't be everyone to everyone. So, without further ado, I'm going to talk about Enneagram today. And if you know Enneagram, there are a few experts here. Today we have Cynthia and we have Cohen. We all know Enneagram. Who else know Enneagram? All right, that's very good. So, on your table, there is a stack of cards divided by a small slip of paper. Every table has one. Can everyone take one set of 12 cards? So, just pass around, all right? Okay, it's divided by a small slip of paper. Please, everyone, take one.
I'm going to pass this around.
Yeah.
Pass this around. All right, help each other out. Help each other out. We have always been facilitator, or we may be a bit slow trying to help ourselves. So make sure you have 12 cards. Huh? Nine? You only have nine? No, you have 12. 12. It's all supposed to be 12. 12 cards. Who do not have 12? All right. Everyone has 12? If you are short of any cards, please let me know. There are two cards that I found on the floor. All right, if you are short of this card, please let me know. Okay. Okay. Share later.
We need another set.
You don't have a set? I have another set here. Let's not waste time. All right.
Thank you.
Okay, so if you don't have a set, don't worry. I will give it to you. Now, everyone today will walk away with one set of cards. It's for you to keep. Because today, we are celebrating the new Expo. Right? So everyone will get a set. And you can bring it back. Please help me take a picture and make those who didn't come today jealous. All right, so are you ready? Can you do me a favor? Pick up these 9 cards and arrange them in front of you in this manner. This one.
Oh, what we see on that?
Yes. Okay, so to make it simple, there is actually an index where you can see all 9, so you don't have to arrange physically, but you can arrange. You can arrange, so have some space. Please arrange these cards. It's very important that you do this exercise.
It's Andrew, a little bit different than the 2 and 3.
It's okay, just follow this. Just follow this. It's okay, just follow this one. Just follow this, okay? Just follow this. Sorry? No cut. Maybe later, okay? Yeah, later on. Extra here. Extra here. Okay, guys, are you done? Are you arranged this way? Okay, good. 3x3. Now, kindly settle down. This is what I like you to do. Okay, I need you to keep quiet. Spend time with yourself. Don't ask anybody any question. Don't ask whether you need extra cards. It's not your issue. I will give everybody a set of cards. I want you to do this. I want you to look at these 9 cards, be on the screen or next or just in front of you. I want you to resonate with every picture you see. You need to feel every energy in each picture. I want you to select one picture from every column. Column, okay, column. One picture of every column that you feel you resonate with that picture. Please do not choose this because you like gardening. It will be a mistake. Please do not choose this because you like to go to the gym. This is wrong energy. Please do not choose this because you like yoga. This is wrong. So you got to look at the energy of the picture itself. I want you to select one picture out of each column. I give you 30 seconds. Each column. Yes, take it out. Column, not rows, please. Always, when I do this, always there'll be people making mistakes, row and column. Yes, okay, after you select the 3, stack up everything for one side. Okay? After you have picked the 3, put everything one side. We're gonna do it fast. All right, are you done?
Yep.
Okay, you have final 3. Now, this is the next step. I want you to now select your final 3 and rearrange them from top to bottom. The one that most resonates with you, put it on top. The one that least resonates with you, put it at the bottom. The one that's in the middle, you put it in the middle. So 1, 2, 3. All right? Good. Now, to make it easier for you, can you see that on the screen right now, there's already a number? Yeah. I want you to write down the 3 numbers that you have chosen. These 3 numbers that you have chosen, you see, you have 3 numbers, right? Please don't forget these 3 numbers. Are you all done? Okay, are you all done? I'm not going to repeat this. You done? I'm going to move on. Too much info? Oh my goodness, this is so simple. All right. Okay, all right, let's move on. You got your 3 numbers?
Yes.
Please add a 0 behind, and this weekend, go and try your luck on 4D. Just kidding. Do you want to know the combination of that number?
Yes.
I'm gonna give you the Da Vinci code right now. Okay, so the first number is usually what people would have recognized. It's obvious that you are that type. The second number is known to very few people, but that is the engine, the power that drives your personality. The last number is amazing. It's known to you only. That it's your potential. That is when all else fail, that will emerge. Now, that is just theory. But I'm going to tell you now what those numbers mean. Are you ready? I'm going to tell you 9 stories of 9 different types of speakers. And perhaps you'll laugh. Okay? Now, I want to talk about this number. Number 1, the grass cutting card. Who choose number 1 as your first card? Can I see your hands? First card? Oh, only 1. Okay. Who choose number 1 in any of this, any of the 3 cards you have, but just not number 1? Okay, very good. So, what I'm about to say, you may not like to hear, but I do not know you personally, I'm just saying it objectively. Please don't throw rotten eggs at me. I'm just going to deconstruct. You are a perfectionistic speaker. You enjoy, you have the most integrity. You are extreme, you are structured, you are systematic. You love learning methodology. You just love details. You show the way. You lead by example. This is the way. No other way. You are also hard to please. You are very dedicated. You have high standard. You are very disciplined. You are able to put very complex issues together. Now, a perfectionistic person is not someone who is very mindful about how things should be done. That person, it's called perfectionist when they impose their standard on you. I am the standard. If you don't pass my standard, you fail. That is a perfectionist. Well, there's nothing wrong with that. So, I'm going to give you, every time we have a summary slide, the one that's on top is when you're feeling super. The one that is in the middle, you're feeling stable. The one that is at the bottom, you're feeling stressed. Why is it that sometimes we perform at a high level, sometimes we perform at a low level? It's because we always fluctuate between super and stress, right? And it depends on who likes you, right? If you are a perfectionist, Irene, I may say you are full of integrity. But if Tim don't like you, you are nano person, right? I'm not saying that he just said it to me. I'm just giving you an example. So a perfectionistic person is someone who set the standard. You have a lot of integrity. You are very process-oriented. You are a gatekeeper. Your only challenge is sometimes to micromanage. And that is going to be your pain because you are so spot on with details. All right, now let's go to number two. Who choose the helping card? The number two. Can I see your hands? Oh, that's very good. Can you recognize? Can you just zoom in? Can I see your hand here? If you're short of money, please go to those with hands raised. Because they are such a good giver. They are the giving speakers. They do more than necessary. Sometimes they are generous, they are nurturing, they are a very good coach. They are so natural. What kind of leadership do they display? Servanthood leadership. They just want to serve. They are the modern day Mother Teresa. Yeah? Father Teresa. They have a need to be needed. I just want you to want me, right? So, yeah, they are very warm. They can deal with all sorts of difficult people. So during training, when you have difficult people, participants in your class, you're okay with that. You can deal with that. You have very good sense of humor. You serve a lot. Everyone is great. You are selfless. You're willing to help. You are just pure selfless. But you know what's your struggle? Your struggle is you just do not know how to turn people down. You do not know how to say no. And that is something that you detest, but you love it. You just want to suffer in silence. The more you suffer, the more self-worth you have, right? Now, there's nothing wrong with that because every type will need another person. So I'll just introduce you to nine. And I'll tell you how you can be evolved to be a better speaker. So, it's one person I can think of is Ron Kaufman. Right? This, Ron Kaufman. Now let's come to number three. Who chose the competitive running card? Can I see your hands? Oh, you are the most dangerous speakers around. Let me tell you why. You are inspirational, motivational, visionary. You are successful. You are very image conscious. You like to be seen in the best light. Right? Yeah? You are likely to be the first one to talk about how big your audience are in the keynote. Right? If you have an ex-president in your audience, you will be the first one to rush there and take a selfie and post on social media. Yeah. Am I right? Guess who I met? Now, there's something wrong with this because it is very inspiring to see a speaker showing that life can be interesting. So this is how it goes. You are very optimistic. You are very motivational. You love KPI. You just want to measure your success with all sorts of dashboards, right? This year, 8,000. Next year, I make sure I have 8,001 in the audience. I just want to get better. Anything is good. You are highly motivational. You are very on the ball. It's very easy to spot your profile. A lot of certificates, a lot of trophy in the office. Yeah? To you, matter, actually, it's so important. Guess what? I am like that. Right? Now, they are natural as a keynote speaker. Right? They work hard. They are just emotionally shut down. And that is your biggest weakness. You don't do small talk. You don't like to share your emotions. All right? You just don't want to be vulnerable. And that is going to be the area you're going to improve. Moving on. Let's talk about four. Okay, so this is tech deck. Don't worry, I'll share this deck with everyone. Sorry? Okay, so these two are the same column. You just look at the rows. So first row, second row, and third row. So I just split it up in two. If not, this whole thing will be a lot of words. But don't worry, I share this deck with every one of you. You just pick the number that you like. Oh, by the way, do you think the first card is really you?
No.
Do you think the first card is really you? How many of you think that the first card is really you? Okay, that is a test. Turn to the back of the card. You will see a list of questions. Take a picture of that of those questions and send it to three best buddies. If they say, yeah, this is so spot on, this is you, man, that means you know yourself very well. Yeah? If your friends say, this is BS, this is not you at all, that means two things. One, they don't know you. Two, you don't know yourself. All right, so moving on, number four. Who chose the crayon card? Can you see her? Oh, no wonder. Congratulations, you are the most creative type of all. Why? You are the best storyteller. You are emotional. You have authentic leadership. You are likely to be very talented. You're original. And you're likely to be very sensual. Really. And that's a compliment. Why? Let's put it this way. They connect with the world through a lot of emotions, through a lot of intuition. They have a strong sense of aesthetic. They just want to connect with this world. They see so much beauty and so much complexity. But they often say things people find hard to understand. Have you ever had speakers who speak in coded message? Has anyone observed the clouds lately? They seem to tell us something today. Can you feel it? Yeah? No. Oh, you mean Tim's, right? Yeah, I thought so too, you know. Okay, all right. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. Everyone is different. If you're a good storyteller, continue to be a good storyteller. That is going to be your bait. But what I'm going to share to you is this. The thing that makes you super will also be the thing that makes you stressful. Because your struggle in life, listen, is self-destruction. You don't believe that success is just at your doorstep. It's just here. And you are here. And sometimes you just tell yourself, maybe I'm not ready. Maybe someone else turn. Maybe I'm good enough. Do you have a lot of maybe? Do me a favor. The next time you see or smell success, just go for it. It's your time. Number five. Who chose this Sherlock Holmes card? Can I see your hand? Can I see your hand? Okay, look at this. Congrats, you are the smartest guy in the room. Because you love all this. You love case studies, statistics, research, thesis, thought leadership. You are the most unlikely speaker. You are not meant to be one, but you are a functional speaker. Because given a choice, you rather keep quiet and sit at one corner. Why do I say that? Look at this. You play well by the side. You are perfect for crisis management. You are almost emotionless. Hey, man. Yeah? Let's be very subjective and let's discuss what went wrong. Yeah, it's almost hard to talk to them because, for example, how do you feel about certain things? It depends on what you want. This answer, this question can be approached in 4 different angles, 5 different levels, right? It's almost frustrating to talk to someone who has a lot of knowledge, but precisely, you are so cool and collected, you are the best person to have a third-party opinion because you see everything. You have a pair of eyes that is like panoramic. 3 hours, no talking in the meeting, and you can see everything. But let me tell you what is the biggest struggle of speakers like that. You want to know? You are the poorest decision maker. Because you need all the info in your life to make a decision. There is no such thing. We all need to move on with some unknown. Okay, number 6. Who chose this? I can see a lot of 5 energy here in the room. So when you're spinning super, you are perspective. You are feeling stressed. You are cynical. You're compartmentalized. You're totally eccentric. And you know what? For a 5, too close too soon is always a problem. They don't like a lot of physical touch. Yeah? The best is to keep some distance, right? So, are you ready for the next one?
Yeah.
Let's talk about the teamwork card. Who chose the 6, the teamwork 6? Okay, no wonder we don't have any teamwork here. All right, okay, let's go. Can I see your name? Can I see your hand? Okay, congrats. You are the most complicated of all. Because on the one hand, life, your world is a jungle out there. You have a lot of checklists, contingency plans, you are devil's advocate. You just need security. And you sometimes contradict yourself. You love to have routine. You know what's the problem? People cannot say, don't worry. Because you start to worry. Yeah. You are like a zebra looking for a lion. Why? Yeah, you're a zebra looking. Because you need danger to confront your insecurity. When the lion is nowhere to be found, you do not make any decisions. But when the lion appears, there, now, here will be safer. Now you know why they're so complicated. Because they often ask this question that has no answer. The question is, what if? What if has no answer? No definite answer. When I was doing dating agency, when I was trying to match men and women, I have the most type of people who are type 6 who remain single for a long time. Because they always ask, life is a gamble. What if I marry the wrong guy? Right? Yeah, that is a very, very interesting question. But if you are a type 6, you enjoy routine. There's no problem doing the same thing for 20 years. In fact, you do much, much better. You can dig a very deep hole and develop fully. Now, so this is the model. When you are having a good time, this is who you are. When having a bad time, this is what you are. So when you say maybe, see how it goes, you are displaying attributes of a loyalist. Now, this is interesting. Last 3. Who chose the spontaneous card, number 7? Can I say, that's very good. You are the most happy-go-lucky people in the world. You are the most fun. Everybody loves you in the room. You have high energy. You are life wire. You are a fun speaker. You love activity, you love a lot of interaction, you hate rules, you are very distracted, you are so playful, you just want to disperse your energy. But your struggle is this. People who know you after a while felt that you are an F1 car and they are the pit stop. Have you seen an F1 car? Woo! Hey, how are you, brother? Okay. Yeah, hey, how are you, Florence? Long time no see. Okay. So they have a lot of energy, but speakers like that, a lot of people find hard to develop a deep connection because you have no problem finding fun even in the worst situation. And that is the value. You are a risk taker. You see the big picture so well that you get bored when someone talk too much detail because you already see XYZ when someone mentioned ABC. Isn't that true? Isn't that true that your attention span is both your strength and also your weakness? So you are excellent when it comes to planning D&D. So EP says D&D, please look for the 7. But for EXCO member, maybe you should try somebody else. Okay, they may not last 1 year. Just kidding, Eugene. I know you are 7. Okay, all right. You last 2 years. Oh, that's very good. You have evolved, right? You evolved. So when you're feeling super, you are fun. When you are feeling stressed, you are superficial. This is the perception that people have of you. That you are fun, but actually you may be superficial. You may be hyperactive, or you may be ADHD. Yeah. Okay, last two. Who chose the strongman number 8 card? No wonder. You are the mover and shaker of the world. Yeah? You are Trump in disguise. Just kidding. Why? Why do I say that? Because you take initiative, self-confident, decisive. You are almost confrontational. You have great strength. Now, make a guess. Who do you think I'm talking about in APSS? The other Andrew, all right? The not so good looking one? Yeah, okay, just kidding. Okay. He makes fun of me during my inaugural speech, so I'm going to return him a favor. just kidding. We all love him, all right? So, you are independent, you are strong, you just want to fight for anything that's unfair. You are the real influencer in the world because you do not care about what people think of you. You just do your thing. Unlike me with the 3, I'm very concerned about my image. But when you are 8, you don't care damn about what people think of you. You just do it, right? Andrew, you have a bit of 8 in you. Do you feel so? You just go out and make things happen, right? Yeah? So, when you are super, you are confident, inspiring, confrontational, but when you are stressed, you begin to be cut. But guess what? They are not rude people. They just want to get things done. But in the course of getting things done, they hurt people along the way. They didn't know it. They just direct. So forgive people who seemingly are rude. You know, if you're a speaker and you're rude, you're not walking the talk. I have seen a lot of speakers. I have been to a conference where I sat from day one, first speaker, to last day, last speaker. A lot of speakers are not who they are. They're very inspiring when they're on stage, but once they come down, they are a completely different person. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be their friend. I don't want to talk to them because I know that energy out there is not the right energy. Why am I talking about personality? Before I come to the last one, is that you need to find your voice. You need to find your energy. I didn't know what my voice should be when I first started. I tried to be everybody else. I tried to take in all the coaching, all the mentoring, all the advice, and what I got is a lot of good advice. But you know what? They all don't make very much sense to me because what works for you may not work for me. What works for me, I can give you as advice, but it may not work for you. So you got to find who you really are. Last one, who chose this Zen card? Congrats, you are the best people in the world. You are the Dalai Lama and the Nelson Mandela. You are who the world needs to look up to because you think of a bigger good of everyone. You are an excellent natural facilitator. You are a good negotiator. You have consultative leadership. For you are good in almost everything. because you are a peacemaker. You are very assuring, very non-judgmental, very caring, very good listening ear. Your issue is there must be no conflict. Everyone should be happy. So you procrastinate a lot. So you may be a slow person, but you are actually moving for the greater good of the people you are serving. Now, there is no right or wrong about every type. So I'm running out of time. I just want to show you one more thing. Anybody watch this?
One more. You want to go back to take
Oh, sorry. Okay. Yeah. I'm going to steal 5 minutes from you. You may be easygoing, but somebody may think you are oblivious. You may be disengaged. Now, why are we studying this? Now, do you know that Winnie the Pooh is a cartoon that has all these nine types in this cartoon? Do you know who is Winnie the Pooh? What type is she? She's a nine, a friend to all. This guy, Tigger, is a seven. It's happy-go-lucky, right? So, I want to share this takeaway, okay? Okay, never mind. I'll give you a size, don't take a picture. Take action. The left column, it's about your emotions. The right, the center column, is about your rationale, your thinking. And the right, it's about your gut feel. If your first number come from the left, you are more of an emotional speaker. You connect by emotions. If a first card comes from the center, you connect through the mind. You connect through knowledge. What happens if your first card comes from the right column? You got no heart and no brain, right? No, just kidding. You go on gut feel, which is the best, the hybrid of the head and the heart. It's gut. Really, if your first card comes from the right, it's awesome. But what does it all mean? I want to tell you about your social style, and this I will end because I'm running short of time. You get the rest of my slides. If you get four, five, or nine, anyone gets two out of these three? Yeah, okay. You don't know your social style? You are a withdrawn person. You wait for people to come to you. Yeah? You prefer to take it easy, right? Anybody two, six, or one? Two out of three of this. Yeah? You are a go the flow person. Yeah? When someone is passive, you'll be more forward-looking. And someone is more aggressive, you will take a seat. Now, how about three, seven, and eight? Anyone has all three? I have all three. You are a assertive person. You just go out there and make things happen. One last one. Do you want to know how do you manage conflict as a speaker with another speaker, or with one of your audience? Okay. Anybody, one, three, and five? Two out of three? One, three, and five, two out of three. No? Yes? Okay, congrats. You are a competent person when it comes to conflict resolutions. Do you know why? There is no chance that a perfectionist will have conflict with anybody. Do you know why? Because he's right and you're wrong. Always, all the time. That's it. Game over. Right? Who has 279 together? Can I see it? Anybody, 279 together? Okay. These people, 279, you must marry them. They are the most positive people in the world. When you have these three numbers together, they make the best partner. Anybody still single there? Oh, no, you're still single. Okay, come and see me later. Okay. Okay, last one. How about four, six, and eight? You got two out of three of this?
All three.
All three. Okay, I don't have very good news for you. So, are you ready? You are a reactive person. A four will say, why me? This is so unfair. A six, finish. This time sure die already. Sure finish. It's the end of the world. How about a challenger? Do you know who I am? Do you dare to do this to me? Yeah. So, they are reactive. Now, as speakers, we all have to understand ourselves because these nine types is also found among the people that you are serving. They have different learning style, they have different buying habits, they have different negotiation style. So learning how to profile yourself not only makes you a better speaker, it makes you a better business person. It makes you have less distance to travel. It saves you a lot of time. You can predict behavior. You can preempt decisions. And that is what I want to talk about. How can we become better speaker? And with this, our goal. Can I see number one again? All the ones. Do you know who you need to work with to be a better speaker? You need to find all the seven. Can all the seven put your hand? So all the one, look at the seven. You need them because you are opposites. You're really opposites. And that is a solution for involvement. You got to find someone so different from you. We always end up marrying our opposites. Do you agree? Yeah? Yes? We always end up having an affair with people exactly the same as us. Just kidding. Just kidding, okay? Cut. Who is 2-2? Do you know who do you need? All the truths. You need all the force in your life. You need to find people who are creative. Look at the line. Creative people will tell you to spend time with yourself. Take care of yourself first. Who are the threes? Threes, you need to find the six. They watch your back very well. They ask you more questions. Who are the fours? You need to find the perfectionists. They give you structure. They give you system. Who are the five? You need to find all the Donald Trump disguise because they kick your butt for you. Yeah, they make you go to action. Number six? No six? Seven, you know who you need? You need to look for all the five. Yes, because they have to dig deeper. All the eight? You need to find all the Mother Teresa. All the eight, you need to look for two. All the nine, look for three. Now this is what I want to share to you. You want to be iconic, you got to first learn about yourself. Because that message comes from knowing who you are. I didn't know my voice. I didn't know my message. Frederick told me, for 7 years, he has heard me speak. He always think I spoke on the wrong topic. And I agree. Because 7 months ago, or 8 months ago, I had a stroke. I thought my life is over because half my body couldn't move. Doctor say, 6 months, you'll see some recovery. I told him, I'm a very busy person. I don't have time to wait 6 months. How about 1 month? And I did it in 1 month. I was a miracle. My hemorrhage was so big. My brain actually bleed. So I did offer surgery. I do self-healing. I went back home and I did a lot of exercise. There's nothing your brain cannot accomplish. You got to talk to yourself. And as speakers, the first person you need to speak to is ourselves. Because to be iconic is to have a lot of reflection on who we really are to the world. When you know that you are different, you will begin to make a difference. Thank you very much for hearing me.
Thank you so much, Andrew. We have a gift for you. Thank you for bringing all this information and knowledge.
This is for you.
Thank you. Yeah. And you got the book for this. Great. There we go. Okay. Thank you.